Hello, welcome back, boys and girls. Today's story is called Buddy's Magic Needle, A Little Dog's Big Adventure, written by Dennis Glennon. Now, this remarkable book is about a sweet little golden retriever and his adventures through the woods. Now, let's see what happens. Let's get started. Buddy was resting on the porch one spring morning when the sky turned dark. He looked for his mom and dad, and he looked for his brothers and sisters, but Buddy was all alone. Now Buddy was scared, and suddenly thunder boomed and lightning flashed. Buddy was very scared. He scrambled up the porch and he ran. He ran away from the scary thunder, away from the bright lightning, and away from the dark, dark sky. And he raced into the foggy forest. And Buddy ran fast and far. And soon, he was very, very lost. Now, Buddy wished he was home. He didn't like being lost, and he didn't like being alone. And then, he saw something. It looked like his mommy. And he started to run to her, but stopped. It wasn't his mommy. It was a pretty deer. And he called out to ask for help. But the shy lady deer lifted her tail and bounded away. And then the rain stopped. And Buddy knew it was time to find his way home. Maybe if I can get higher, I will see my way home, he thought. And so he climbed way up to the top of a rocky ledge, but he did not see his house. And the climbing made him very tired. And then he plopped down on a wooden bridge that crossed a small woodland stream. And then he wondered, will I ever get home? Now Buddy peered down at the juggling stream, and then he noticed a forest path in the distance. Maybe that's the way home. Now, near the path was a beautiful butterfly. I'm trying to find my way home, he told her. But the butterfly waved her wings and kindly replied, I wish I could help, but I'm just a simple butterfly. There are stronger and wiser creatures at the pond. Now follow the path. And when Buddy reached the pond, he saw a colorful turtle sunning himself and barked. Can you help me find my home? And the frightened turtle cried, Don't eat me! I won't eat you, said Buddy. But the turtle had already disappeared under the water. And then Buddy said hello to a frog. But the frog just hid him suspiciously. Now Buddy saw a friendly looking moose across the pond, and he crawled into a canoe at the water's edge and shouted, "Can you help me find my way home?" And then the moose smiled. "I know every inch of the forest. I can help you." So Buddy told the moose he didn't live in the forest. "Oh my!" exclaimed the moose. "Then you need a wiser and more well-traveled creature than I. Now follow the path at the end of the pond. Good luck." So Buddy thanked the moose as he watched some loons float by with their newborn. And he gave a short bark, and they quickly swam away. And then Buddy thought, "They must be looning." And then he watched another duck run across the pond. "Oh no, a retriever!" she squawked. "I won't hurt you," Buddy yelled, but the duck was gone. Now Buddy followed the moose's advice, and off he went to find the path out of the forest. And along the way, he met another moose with two young cows. "How much farther to the end of the pond?" he asked her. "Not far," she answered. "But go right where the path splits. Danger lies to the left, friends to the right. Good luck." And when Buddy came to the split in the path, he remembered the mother moose's warning. Danger to the left and friends to the right. But Buddy was very young, and he didn't know which way was left or right. So he chose a path. And very soon, he knew it was the wrong path. Now his mommy had told him about foxes, and they're quite sneaky, and they like to play tricks. So Buddy turned around and he ran. He ran back to the split in the trail and quickly followed the right path out of the forest. Now Buddy was led into a clearing. And Buddy tilted his head and listened. "What can that be?" he wondered. And Buddy ran into an old barn and jumped high up onto the tractor seat to try to see what could be making the silly noises. Can you help me find my home?" Buddy called, but the cows just stared. Now one nutty brown cow made a rude face at Buddy, and he decided they were not very helpful. So Buddy continued along the forest, and a chubby-faced chipmunk was storing nuts in his cheeks, getting ready for winter. And Buddy asked, "Can you help me find my way home?" And the well-mannered chipmunk didn't answer right away. He knew not to talk with his mouth full.
"No, but I have some nuts I can share with you,"
and Buddy had forgotten how hungry he was. And the nuts were delicious. Now Buddy heard a bluebird sing. Can you help me find my way home, Mr. Bluebird? Now the wise owl will know, the bluebird answered. He's perched high in the great tree, overseeing the forest and beyond. But hurry, little puppy, it's getting late, and Mr. Great Horned Owl flies at night. So Buddy raced to find the wise owl. Screeched the great horned owl.
I'm Buddy, and I'm lost and can't find my way home. Can you help me?
And the great horned owl cocked his head and thought,
there's a barn further down the path. Go inside, climb up the hay, into the magic window. Look through it and listen to the whispers on the wind. Trust in your heart, believe in yourself. If your faith is strong, the magic window will take you home.
Now Buddy could see the barn with the magic window, and he ran inside and climbed up the hay, and he found the magic window the wise owl had told him about. It didn't look magic to Buddy, but from it, he could see all the places he had been. The deep woods, the rock ledge, the bridge, the forest path, and the pond. And Buddy remembered the words of the wise owl. He listened for the whispers on the wind. Buddy trusted in his heart, and his faith was strong. He could see his family searching for him, and he felt how much they missed him. He then pictured himself at home with them. And suddenly, by the power of the magic window, Buddy was lifted home.
I think I hear Buddy. Is that him panting on the porch?
Now Buddy seemed to appear from nowhere.
Hey everyone, I'm finally home.
And Buddy told his family about how the loud thunder and scary lightning made him run into the woods. He told them how he'd asked the forest animals for help, and how the great horned owl had led him home. And after telling his family all about his adventures, Buddy was very, very tired, and he drifted off to sleep in his favorite place. He knew he wanted to explore the world again one day, and he wanted to visit with the friendly animals that had helped him along the way. The moose, the butterfly, the chipmunk, but not the fox. For now, though, Buddy was just glad to be home with his family. And the big world and magic window adventures were puppy tales that he'd save for another day. Wow, what a wonderful wonderful puppy tail story. I love this book. Thank you so much for joining us again, boys and girls, for this wonderful story time. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'll see you soon.